Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You are welcome to another chemistry class for this week. Today we shall discuss the topic water off crystallization, hydrated salts, and anhydrous salts. Water off crystallization is a definite amount of water, some salt, or some substances chemically combined with when they form salts from their aqueous solution. Water off crystallization is the amount of water associated with some salts when they form from their aqueous solution. These water molecules are loosely bound to that salt, and they can easily be separated from such salts, particularly when the salts are heated or when the salts are exposed to the atmosphere. Hydrated salts. Hydrated salts are salts that contain water off crystallization in its molecule. It means for a salt to be hydrated, it must contain water off crystallization. So, hydrated salts are also known as crystalline salts. I want you to take note here. All hydrated salts are crystalline salts, but we have some salts that are crystalline salts but not hydrated salt. We have some salts that are crystalline but they don't contain water off crystallization, but all hydrated salts, they are crystalline salts. Crystalline salts will lose all or part of its water off crystallization when they are exposed to the atmosphere or when they are heated. Examples of hydrated salts are copper 2 tetrahydrosulfate 6 pentahydrate, CuSO4 5H2O. CuSO4 is the hydrated salt that contain water off crystallization. That 5 molecule of water, 5H2O, is the water of crystallization contained in that particular salt. Another example is sodium thiosulfocarbonate 4 decahydrate, Na2CO3, 0.10H2O. That 10 molecules of water is the water of crystallization contained in sodium thiosulfocarbonate 4. Another example is magnesium tetrahydrosulfate 6 heptahydrate, MgSO4.7H2O. That 7 molecule of water, 7H2O, is the water of crystallization contained in the molecule of magnesium tetrahydrosulfate 6. This water molecule, that is water of crystallization contained in this hydrated salt, provide shape and color to the hydrated salt. Now, anhydrous salts. Anhydrous salts are residual salts that is left behind on eating hydrated salt. Anhydrous salts are the residual salts that is left behind when some hydrated salts are heated or when they are exposed to the atmosphere. That is, when hydrated salts lose its or part of water crystallization, the residual salt left behind will form anhydrous salt. For example, copper 2 tetrahydrosulfate 6 pentahydrate, when lose 5 molecules of water present in it, it will leave a residual salt, copper 2 tetrahydrosulfate 6, that is anhydrous salt of copper sulfate. Also, sodium thiosulfocarbonate 4 decahydrate, when leaf time will, when exposed to the atmosphere, it releases 10 molecules of water present in it as water of crystallization to produce anhydrous sort of Na2CO3 and so on. I want you to take note here. When anhydrous salt combined with water of crystallization, hydrated salt will be produced. For example, CuSO4, copper 2, tetrasulfate 6, when they combine with 5 molecules of water combined together to form aqueous solution, hydrated salt of copper sulfate will be produced. Now we're going to look at calculation of numbers of mole of water of crystallization associated with some hydrated salts. Hydrated salts loses all or part of its water of crystallization when they are heated. When hydrated salts are heated or when they are exposed to the atmosphere, they lose all or part of its water of crystallization. The number of mole of water of crystallization lose or contained in that particular hydrated salt can be calculated using the following relation. This is relation 18N. This N refers to as numbers of mole of water of crystallization present in that compound. Why 18 here is obtained from the molar mass of water divided by molar mass of anhydrous salt, that is anhydrous part of hydrated salt is equal to mass of water lost all over mass of anhydrous salt. I told you that N is the number of moles of water of crystallization. This N is an whole number, positive whole number. So whenever you are calculating the number of moles of water of crystallization, your answer must be given as whole number. Now, example, 6.25 gram of blue hydrated copper 2 tetrasulfate 6 CuSO4.Na2O was gently heated in a crucible until the mass remaining was 4.00 gram of white anhydrous copper 2 tetrasulfate 6. Calculate the number of moles of water of crystallization. We are given RAM of the copper to be 63.5, sulfur to be 32.0, oxygen to be 16, hydrogen is equal to 1. Solution here, we are going to apply the formula I gave to you. First of all, we are going to look at some parameter given here. We are given mass of hydrated salt, CuSO4.Na2O to be 6.25 gram. We are given mass of anhydrous, because when 6.25 gram of hydrated copper 2 sulfate was heated, the remaining mass was 4.0 gram. It means mass of anhydrous when 6.25 gram of hydrated copper sulfate is heated is 4.00 gram. In order to calculate mass of water lost, mass of water lost is equal to mass of hydrated salt minus mass of anhydrous salt. So we subtract 4 from 6.25 gram, we are going to get 2.25 gram. So in order to calculate the molar mass of anhydrous salt, because when we are given CuSO4.Na2O, CuSO4 is anhydrous part of that hydrated copper two surface. So in order to calculate the molar mass of an ideal salt, we are going to add the RAM of each element present in that compound, and we are going to get 159.5 because RAM is given in the question. We are going to substitute the parameter into the formula given. So you substitute, you are going to get the value of N, that is number of mole of water of crystallization, to be equal to what, 5. Normally the answer was 4.9 something, but I told you that number of mole of water of crystallization must be a whole number. So this is where we're going to stop for today. In our next period, we're going to complete the remaining part of subtopics under acids, bases and salts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.